In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. May the working of your mercy, O Lord, we pray, direct our hearts aright. For without your grace, we cannot find favor in your sight. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Del libro del profeta Jeremías. En aquel tiempo, dijo Jeremías, el Señor me instruyó y yo comprendí. Él me explicó lo que hacía. Yo era como un manso cordero que es llevado a degollar, y no sabía lo que tramaba contra mí, diciendo, talemos el árbol en su pleno vigor, arranquémoslo de la tierra de los vivos, y que su nombre no se pronuncie más. Ahora tú, Señor de los ejércitos, justo juez, que sondeas lo más íntimo del corazón, haz que yo vea tu venganza contra ellos, porque a ti he encomendado mi causa. Palabra de Dios. En ti, Señor, me refugio. En ti, Señor, me refugio. En ti, Dios mío, me refugio, de mis perseguidores sálvame. No permitas que algunos como fieras me destrocen y nadie me rescate. En ti, Señor, me refugio. Tú que llegas, Señor, a lo más hondo del corazón humano, tú júzgame, Señor, según mis méritos, conforme a mi inocencia de tu falla, apoya al hombre recto, pon fin a la maldad de los malvados. En ti, Señor, me refugio. Tengo mi escudo en Dios, que salva a los de recto corazón. Alabaré al Señor por su justicia y cantaré el nombre del Altísimo. En ti, Señor, me refugio.
Praise to you, Lord. So division occurred. crowd because of him. Some of them even wanted to arrest him, but no one laid hands on him. So the guards went to the chief priests and Pharisees, who asked them, "Why did you not bring him?" The guards answered, "Never before has anyone spoken like this man." So the Pharisees answered them, "Have you also been deceived? Have any of the authorities or the Pharisees believed in him? But this crowd which does not know the law is accursed." Nicodemus, one of their members who had come to him earlier, said to them, "Does our law condemn a man before it first hears him and finds out what he is doing?" They answered and said to him, "You are now from Galilee also, are you? Look and see that no prophet arises from Galilee." Then each went to his own house. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Lord Jesus Christ. As we are here every day celebrating Mass for the intentions that we have already, but also for the improvement of our state around the world, the improvement of our health and well-being, we also begin to wonder about the causes or the reasons why God is allowing us to suffer through this pandemic. And we need to make sure that we are not like the Pharisees and those in leadership during this time of Jesus. We need to make sure that we do not jump to conclusions. We need to realize that in every generation since the beginning of humanity, there has been a sin. There has been sin. There has been a distance between us and God of our own making. Each and every one of us, none of us can claim to be perfectly holy and saintly and without sin. Each and every one of us participates in sin. And so each and every one of us can blame sin as the root cause for the pandemic that's happening, the sin of our generation. No. I think that in each generation, we can all improve and get better in terms of getting closer to God. And so this is something that God can allow to happen to us. But we shouldn't be like the Pharisees trying to judge one another or allowing division to enter in between us, whether we're blaming one group or another group, or believers or non-believers. But we should accept part of we should accept that this is a time to get closer to God. We should accept that this is a time to learn what is really important, which is our relationship with God, which is the love which we have experienced from Him and the love which we can show others. During this time, let us not get caught up in trying to find someone to blame, but let us try to understand that God loves each and every person and that God wants the salvation of each and every person. God wants a relationship with each and every person. Let us take this time when we have more time on our hands to study our own relationship with God and to see if there's any way we can draw even closer to Him. Solo quiero decir que pienso que hay una tentación a tratar de interpretar esta enfermedad alrededor de todo el mundo como es una culpa de un grupo o otro grupo, de un pecado o otro pecado. Yo quiero, en esta lectura de hoy, escuchemos sobre los fariseos división entre ellos. Y no queremos esta división. No queremos dar la culpa a un grupo o otro grupo. Yo pienso que ese es el tiempo a reevaluar nuestra relación con Dios, nuestra relación en la iglesia y con toda la humanidad. Este no es el tiempo a buscar una persona o un grupo de personas y buscar y dar la culpa, pero entre cada uno de nosotros podemos mirar que podemos mejorar nuestra relación con Dios. Cada uno de nosotros tenemos pecado, entonces no podemos buscar por dar la culpa a nadie. Ojalá que en ese tiempo podamos ser unidos, aceptando la presencia y amor de Dios y tratando de ayudar a todos los demás, especialmente espiritualmente, pero también físicamente. Juntos vamos a orar por el bien de la iglesia y del mundo. Por la iglesia, for the church, let us pray for Pope Francis and for our bishops that they continue to make good and wise decisions, helping us to protect our spiritual health, but also giving us words so that we can continue to grow even closer to God during this time. We pray to the Lord. Lord, our prayer. Queremos orar por los líderes en el gobierno y también en áreas de estudio, que Dios va a guiarles también a elegir bien, a tener decisiones buenas por todos los demás, especialmente los pequeños. Roguemos al Señor. Let us pray for the needy. Let us pray especially for those who are serving in hospitals and other areas of care, of medical care, that God keep them well. We pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Queremos orar por nuestra parroquia, que podamos continuar a alcanzar a nuestra gente, especialmente los padres y madres que están en formación, que tienen niños en formación. Que Dios va a continuar a buscar para la formación de sus niños y cumplir este año para recibir los sacramentos, oraremos al Señor. Te rogamos, Señor, por las intenciones de esta misa, por el eterno descanso de Estefanía Hurtado Tapia y Nabor y Cotán Vázquez, oraremos al Señor. Te rogamos, Señor. Heavenly Father, we thank you for the stories that we hear in the Bible. We ask you to continue to help us find connections that will serve us for today. We ask you to keep us from having a spirit of being judges, of judging one another. We ask you to keep us united in turning to you, asking for your help, and reaching out to all those who need help, especially spiritually, but also physically. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Bendito sea, Señor Dios universo, por este pan, fruto de la tierra y del trabajo del hombre, que recibimos de tu generosidad, y ahora te presentamos, será para nosotros pan de vida. Bendito seas por siempre, Señor. Bendito seas, Señor Dios universo, por este vino, fruto de la vida y de tu rama, del hombre, que recibimos de tu generosidad, y ahora te presentamos a ser para nosotros vivir de salvación. Bendito seas por siempre, Señor. Ornamos para que ese sacrificio mío de ustedes se agrade a Dios Padre Todopoderoso.
El Señor es un sacrificio para la alabanza y gloria de su nombre, para nuestro bien en toda su santa iglesia.
Recibe, Señor, con agrado nuestras ofrendas y atrae hacia ti voluntariamente nuestras voluntades de ustedes, por Jesucristo nuestro Señor.
Amén.
El Señor esté con ustedes.
Y con todos.
Levantemos el corazón. Demos gracias al Señor nuestro Dios.
Es justo y necesario.
En verdad es justo y necesario, es nuestro deber, salvación, darte gracias siempre en tu lugar. Señor Padre Santo, Dios Todopoderoso y Eterno, porque con el ayuno corporal refrenas nuestras pasiones, elevas nuestro espíritu, nos fortaleces y recompensas por Cristo, Señor nuestro. Por él celebra tu majestad los ángeles, te adoran las dominaciones, se estremecen los potestades. Te celebran unidos en la alegría de los cielos, las virtudes celestiales y los bienaventurados serafines. Permítenos asociarnos a sus voces, cantando humildemente tu alabanza. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. Save us, Savior of the world, for by your cross and resurrection you have set us free. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Daniel, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the Holy Let us always try to remember to give thanks for everything that God is doing here in our world, even the things that we do not see. Let us pray. May your holy gifts purify us, O Lord, we pray, and by their working render us fully pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Look upon your people, O Lord, and as they draw near to the coming festivities, bestow upon them abundance of heavenly grace, that helped by the consolation of this world, they may be impelled readily towards higher goods that cannot be seen. Through Christ our Lord. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
Yeah.